Ben. What did you Ben? Undying plus plus one. Undying darks here on EG.
So yeah, Doom is not really just a big deal anymore.
They might. I don't know actually. VG did play Doom once, so maybe EG would respect Ban the Doom.
And even the Tusk is something Ice has been playing a bit of lately.
But. So, yeah, Doom's Ban.
Yeah, there's the Doom Ban.
And here they would Ban SF unless they want to play versus EG's SF. But it is SF Radiant, so
yeah.
Thing is, when you play versus SF Radiant, your entire game is about playing versus SF Radiant, you know. And if you just screw up once, it's SF Radiant. It's like EG's games yesterday versus Liquid. All three games EG had SF Radiant, and then the first game Liquid managed to beat, and then the last two games they weren't able to. They made some bit up like screw up plays, and then they just lost.
Are you surprised to see EG on the Radiant side, Bulba? Or you think that's something they prefer?
No, I think generally Radiant side is a favor for the teams that care a lot about their mid player.
Mm.
So you have Sumail and RTZ. You have basically two mid players on this team. So, and then you have Fear as well. Well, he used to be a mid player. So, three mid players. Well, let's see this Bane. So they're debating whether
they're debating. Yeah, they're definitely.
It's kind of weird though. I guess they're just gonna wait for the time to. But they Tusk. So they're gonna give up EG Bane. Unless thing is, VG has also played SF, but I don't think EG cares about Super's SF on Dire. It doesn't seem like.
It doesn't seem like something they really like.
Yeah, they would not
go
care
toward.
About. If they play versus SF on Dire, I don't think they care as much. EG's debating right now whether to Ban Undying Darkseer or just Ban the SF as well.
5 seconds remaining.
Have we seen Evil Geniuses pull out the Timber Saw yet this tournament?
No,
no.
Yet.
I think it's because
Gyro.
Gyrocopter.
Hmm. Maybe they want the Undying.
Well, they definitely want something if they're not going to get whatever this may be.
Well, since Gyro was banned there, EG wants SF Undying. Like, that's their
ideal.
Yeah,
SF Undying, definitely.
But, so, now EG will play versus SF Undying.
So what, do you think they'll Dazzle, or...
Like Darkseer Wyvern?
They could do that. They probably want the Undying, though.
That's what I, that's exactly what I was thinking, because they banned the Gyro.
They could take, like, Dazzle Undying, or I don't know if they would do that.
That sounds a little weird to them.
Yeah.
That's all PBD talked about when he was on the couch. It was dazzle,
dazzle,
dazzle.
Yeah,
dazzle.
He was just mind gaming us.
Yeah,
mind gaming everybody.
Doesn't actually think the hero is as good as he was talking about.
10 seconds remaining.
But
Darkseer.
Okay.
Darkseer Wyvern.
Darkseer Wyvern or dazzle. Okay.
Dazzle Darkseer.
Wasn't completely bluffing.
So I got one, and you guys got one, and everyone's happy.
Yeah. The Vici take Undying here.
I mean,
the thing is, VG wants a support to help out mid, so they should take. Like, when you pick SF Undying, you need to support the help camp for the SF mid. Yep. Else he's just gonna get crushed. So they need, like, a Wyvern. Dazzle's taken, Bane is banned. So what else is there? There's, like, Rubick. It's generally, OG likes that.
Not this early, though.
Pull out the Bounty Hunter. That's a FY classic.
Yeah, but the Darkseer is very good versus Bounty in the game.
And so is Dazzle.
Yeah. I don't know if they would take the Bounty this early. They could just, like, open up with, like, they also need a hero that can solo Darkseer.
Okay, Undying is the one that they were just gonna go for. So,
okay, EG should Ban Rasta, I think, because VG picked had this lineup that they should Ban like Rasta and Venge if they care. But Venge is not really good at laning versus Darkseer, so I don't know if that is worth banning.
10 seconds remaining.
And VG would probably try and Ban like. Like some of Sumail's mid heroes, like Invoker maybe, Templar Assassin.
They might ban the Quap too, just because they picked up the Undying, right?
Yeah.
Like Quap Huskar, maybe they could be afraid of that. Eh, probably not the Husk.
And EG are just not Huskar players, right? That also don't even give it. Okay, or they're just going to ban it anyways, just to be uniform,
yeah,
I guess.
You don't want to, like,
yeah.
Scenario where.
Don't even give it the chance.
You don't want to start a best of three, basically just losing because of something
so
like that.
So EG bans the Venge.
Yep.
And now they're probably going to Ban Rasta.
Evil geniuses
or,
turn to ban.
Like, Bounty, like you said. I don't know if they would Ban VG's Bounty, though.
I think BPD when I think he was casting one of the games where VG were playing Bounty and he was like, FY when he's playing the Bounty often just has these bad games or gets shut down a lot. So.
I think EG will Ban something and take Wyvern here. That is probably their best play.
You think they'll still take just because of the Darkseer? Even though it's through the Dazzle.
Yes. And Wyvern generally is good hero versus SF as well.
SF, yeah.
No stuns though. No worry of lack of lockdown with that?
You don't need stuns in Dota anymore.
All right.
You just need like one stun. They banned the Phantom Lancer. Good ban by VG there. Because PL is, Artur played it. And all three games were sus, right? Or so two games were sus.
It can be really strong versus the Undying too, because you can insta-kill
the
Tombstone.
They banned the Wyvern then. So, they don't want to give VG Wyvern Undying, and I guess they don't want to take the Wyvern for fear.
Could they get like a Spirit Breaker instead for fear? Goes along with the Darkseer a bit. Could add a lot of pressure on Shadow Fiend.
Yeah, Spirit Breaker is a good
Spirit
pick
Breaker is good, yeah. Maybe they wait for the fourth pick to grab it, but yeah, it's
maybe
still
EG
good.
Could also want the Bounty Hunter to crush the SF. Like in these tournaments, you see what's kind of like China is kind of picking this bounty versus SF, right? So maybe EG kind of takes this bounty to crush VG's SF.
Yeah, other than that, it's like what, Night Stalker maybe? It's a fear kind of hero.
There's Wind Ranger still for Somail. Invoker, there's a Queen of Pain as well.
Yeah, it's still Quap.
And no one's going early Slardar anymore? Has that already fallen off?
Oh, the Jug.
It's a lot of heal. I mean, will Vici go for like an AA still to respond to that? It's push, it's heal.
I think
no one, someone's
want,
getting a mech.
Like Rasta, something like that. Like based on what they picked last time, they played the sign up. They need an ice hero. I don't think he'll play the Undying.
Nah, I think Fenrir, for the most part, plays it exclusively on their team.
You don't get. I've definitely seen Isosize play it. Like,
oh, really?
As far as, okay. Like, yeah, Isosize can
hello,
play it.
Hello, the roaming undying strat that he has.
Yeah,
it's
yeah.
A viral sensation.
Not to say. I don't. Not to disagree with you guys. It's more like, yeah, he's definitely. Definitely will. Like, I feel like it's 50-50 him, Fenrir.
Okay.
But.
What if Fiji just busts out the Logan flipped Abaddon here?
The Logan Abaddon.
Yeah.
No, they already have Darkseer. Do you think they would?
No, Vici.
Oh, Vici, okay.
It's spreading like fire, yeah.
It's really good. I mean, it is very good with their lineup, but they don't really have anything to remove with the shield. Rasta's probably looks best. I'm trying to think of anything else.
Then I'm just seeing two lineups who just want to get together and push and push objectives.
Well,
and it's
VG needs a hero that can lane versus DS in the top lane. Like, so what is there? There's not much.
Isn't Disruptor pretty good? Helps pull back with Glimpse.
Vici took the Spirit Breaker.
That's Ice's hero.
They picked Burning Queen of Pain a bit. It hasn't been phenomenal on the hero, but it seems to be like a kind of hero they may pick for him that lanes pretty well against Darkseer.
Yeah.
Could be. Burning plays everything.
Yeah.
No, they need a fear hero. What does Juggernaut have done is they've banned Wyvern, and they've banned Wyvern, and then they have Dazzle. So, and they took the Jug. Because Wyvern is generally a good hero versus Juggernaut, because you can use a third spell on whoever gets Omni Slashed.
So it could still be Windrunner, even though it's not as great versus like Spirit Breaker and stuff.
And you can also ulti the Juggernaut when he's spinning and cancels TP.
Is there any consideration towards an Ember pick? Like, it's something like Arteezy's been spamming in pubs, both Sumail and Arteezy both play it.
I don't think. I mean, EG wants a hero that can just dominate mid. Yeah, so they're
so Queen. Yeah, it's Queen or Windrunner, I thought there. Turn
to pick. But Spirit Breaker is a good hero versus Queen in the game. Like, Spirit Breaker is actually very good versus the Juggernaut and the Queen. Anti-Mage.
All right. Oh, the Burning AM! It's here!
So the only reason they picked this Anti-Mage is because they needed a hero to lane versus Darkseer. And AM is a good hero versus Queen. But I don't know the stats on these SF Anti-Mage lineups. Like, they're generally way too greedy.
It tends to lose.
Yes, it's too much space. Like, SF needs way too much help. Anti-Mage needs... Like, the game needs to go in Anti-Mage's favor. Like, when you pick SF, you want to run your game around SF. And then when it's AM, you want to run this hero on Anti-Mage. So then you have these very two greedy heroes together. Like, OG ran this at, that tournament they just played. Defense, and Liquid just rolled over them.
Yep. They said it was too greedy.
Yeah.
Super's SF is one of the less greedy SFs, so, like, he'll always go for the mech build pretty much and play a lot more defensively than
Axeman. Maybe Ice is playing that in pubs or something? Axe is a good hero for Juggernaut, maybe that's why they banned it.
Yeah, Jug and Dazzle.
I like the Night Stalker ban, would have been good. Ion Shell right at your face, and then the silence for the AM. So what is Fierce Hero gonna be then? No Spirit Breaker now, no Night Stalker. Some other run at you, potential disable for this AM.
Night Stalker
catch.
Is banned, so...
Could still be Rasta for them.
I think they want catch so they can actually kill the AM.
Rasta
they want like a Lion Lion Rasta
Lion?
Type
Lion
pick.
Or
yeah.
Rasta?
Yeah.
I don't like Lion as a hero.
I just feel like you can't play into AM with no catch here. You vacuum's all you've got. Quap Orchid before AM gets Manta. Like,
so what else? Ags Lion with vacuum? Hell yeah.
Rasta, do they still do just Shaker support at all? They do, right? They did it earlier this tournament.
I don't know if they would pick it here.
I don't think so either. I like the Rasta a lot, but I'm just trying to think of maybe something else.
Skywrath Mage, guys.
The return.
Could happen.
No.
That would be probably one of the more shocking picks for me to see, like, in this tournament in general. Like, Skywrath is going to be one of the, like, the least picked heroes in this patch.
Definitely some catch. But yeah, roster Shaker.
I think EG can take the Rasta and deny VG the Rasta.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what else VG would pick here. They need a FY hero. I'm thinking about what he's played so far in this tournament.
Can you go back for a Rubick?
Rubick is this
still like you look at Brave?
Okay, so Shaker, I did go for the Shaker.
Like Rubick just seems
very good now. Rubick or Shaker?
I don't know though. The hero's so slow, and you have these four melee heroes with the like you have anti like what is your safe lane?
I think you want something stronger than the Rubick because you're gonna have the anti mage playing away from you, and you want to be able to group up with like the SF and Undying at least a bit. Rubick seems a little greedy.
Yeah, if they Rubick, I would favor EG's lineup by a lot.
I mean, if not,
I already favor EG's lineup quite a bit because I think that SF will get pretty crushed. Remaining.
I'm not really seeing it. It's got to be like Rasta Rubick, I guess. I don't know.
5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Skywrath Mage.
Is the Rasta Rubick for what? The
Well. There you go.
I don't know.
I don't know if I like it though.
FY drafting, he's just saying, look, I want to put on a show.
There's
here.
A lot of good spells to steal. He's got like Blink, Quap stuff, you know, Shaker, Grave, obviously Juggernaut ulti.
I mean, Rubick is a good hero versus, he's an okay hero versus Darkseer in lane. He's one of the supports that can kill him.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you can just save your lift. For the
wait for the surge.
Yeah.
Someone was drawing on the map whenever you hear that. It's like they're plotting out a 5-man movement right now, baby.
Or maybe a TP ward, you know. Maybe something less. Maybe something more simple.
Plant the ward there. Go, go, go! What were the odds in this matchup coming in? I can't help but feel
tricked,
like it was
60-40.
He tried. He's like, he's only
put the
like,
camera.
Oh, he's like,
on.
I'm too late.
Camera,
guy.
Camera and glasses. No problem.
Sorry, man.
And they get the zoom in.
The secret's out. Man. He wears glasses.
Dude, you look good in glasses.
I like
glasses. You look good in glasses. I wore glasses.
We're all blind. Right. We're all blind here. We're all gamers.
I can't see shit from here, so. This is on you guys.
You can't?
I'm bad. I have like I'm this close to cataracts, I feel.
So PPD is steeping bottom to ward safe lane.
Got him.
Yep. Anyways, what are your guys?
I like EG's
predictions.
I like EG's. The Shaker I think was a little bit weak. Instead of maybe the Rasta, but overall with the Darkseer and the team fights, you know, they have a
giant
synergy.
Well, they picked the Shaker so that Darkseer can get level 2 top.
Yep.
And
yeah, that's good
after he gives them level 2, he'll run on and rotate on mid.
Mm-hmm.
And if SF plays past river, there's a chance that Shaker will go stun him. But they picked this Rubick, I think. Main reason is like also,
help
like
mid.
You said, to secure mid.
Yeah.
So there'll be a Rubick mid. Basically, they're just going to try lane mid, it looks like. And Darkseer will be soloing with anti-mage.
Like
Undying will just be rotating around, Rubick will be rotating, but generally their focus will be on mid. And if they want to win this game, they need to play around this SF. Like, they need to... Like, this AM as a hero, you don't want to help him too much in a game like this. Because if you help him too much, then this SF is going to get crushed.
Mm-hmm.
So...
And then the AM is never going to be at his final form.
Yeah. Like, the strength of VG versus EG's lineup is that EG only has one stun. And when they need to wait for, like, Queen's... Orchid to really make plays, as well as Shaker's Blink.
Oh, bad manner hit.
That was a Rubick spank right there.
Easy manga regen.
Anti-mage is bottom.
Alright.
What they think is, they thought EG's going aggressive trialing and soloing Darkseer bottom, and then they see the lanes
now
and now this. And this is super good for Darkseer now, because when he sees his anti-mage attacking him, he's gonna see no mana burn. Like AM strength versus Darkseer is at level 1, you just zone the Darkseer out and you just attack him.
It's like, he's missing mana.
Yeah, he knows.
This is a really good game for Universe now. Like, this game is set for him to have a good game.
We saw yesterday what happens when he gets 1v1. That Nyx game, he's getting like two solo kills, so...
But to be fair, Mind Control did kind of 3-2-2 there.
Yeah, at least the second one
especially. The bottle delivery, though, was like, perfect timing. That one was like, you can't really just be like, oh, he's gonna get his bottle here.
Yeah, so Darkseer's gonna get free level 2. And now Rupik is coming. He has no side war though on the Darkseer, so that's his weak. That's gonna be the weakness right now. But AM is gonna be farming under tower. He has no Quelling Blade. This is a sad anti-mage. And Rupik put a safe thin ward.
Not gonna be an easy to get a hold of though. With just one telekinesis, might not be good enough for a surgeon. He's still gonna get the pull. It looks like here. Rupik, nope. He'll take the aggro. Not happening.
Undying doing really well, helping mid. SF already 8 CS. And they have a lane ward, so it really helps out. Super.
Yeah, SF's doing well.
So both teams did a short lane ward and a mid ward.
Yeah, so Rubick will be rotating around mid and mid and top. And Dying will be stacking for Shadow Fiend, protecting him. Shaker will be stacking for Darkseer, I think.
Trying to get some... Maybe they might be able to get it here. Whoa! Dying's coming in. Looks like
he
they're gonna
needs
get
more.
It.
Can he get it? He looks like
he'll the salve. What? He's gonna die denying now. That salve tick.
Oh, it's tombstone now committed here. They want to get a hold of Fear with the help of FY. They toss him back. They're gonna move in. Kobe gets the fissure off, and he will go down.
Man, go expended.
This is a good undying now. Like this undying, he's gonna have a look at him. He got a kill. Then he got the. Yeah, he got really good experience. Level 3, level 3 support and dying at 2 minutes.
He was like, I think it was like 10 XP short of level 2 and SF got dived, because otherwise he could have had the Soul Rip, which would have been able to save the SF, but still really good for Vici.
Yeah, Universe is level 4 before 3 minutes.
Fear TP though.
He needs it, he has no Surge, no mana now.
He's fine.
He's good.
Universe didn't start with a Soul Ring recipe, so he's gonna have to wait for the chicken. Like he has to honestly just go heal, or he's gonna, he's bringing it to him. And Fear Clarity him as well. Looking at bottom lane, how is Ice doing there?
Still good,
yeah, he's getting low. This lane can't really kill, because as soon as they go on him, they'll be able to, he'll be able to charge.
Oh, got him.
Okay, that's really bad from...
That was a solo kill.
Yeah. Yep.
This is just classic, I think. Super sat on this hill, and there's a mid ward on Radiant's hill, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So SF will go there and try and raise, and Queen will just blink on him, and especially level, the prime time for Queen to kill SF is like 1 through 4, right? And then level 5 it gets kind of harder.
Look at this creep wave. Yeah.
Spiritbreaker is getting a lot. Even though he's not getting, he even has some decent CS, he has like close to the amount of same CS as Super.
Level 4 before even 4 minutes, he's doing fine.
He's charging mid.
And it looks like he's gonna take his business elsewhere. Yeah, just gets to the rune.
Double.
Yummy!
So this Undying and Spiritbreaker are doing really well. Because it's all about the levels for Vici's lineup in terms of their offlaners and supports. Like Rubick, Undying, and Spiritbreaker all need level. High level in Tomb. Rubick needs ult, and Spiritbreaker needs his ulti as well.
Bottom lane, Spiritbreaker in a little bit of trouble. They already committed the Blade Fury here. He's looking to juke and jive up. Fear's waiting to cut him off, but he already commits the TP, and he not going to be out. That heal at the end will get him. Peter brings him down.
It's a nice try by Ice, though.
Yeah.
Self TPing.
I mean, you guys talked about the SF AM being kind of greedy. Do you feel like Vici are getting away with it right now, or EG have done enough to get a couple kills on the SF so far?
I mean, EG needs to keep putting the pressure on the SF, right? Like, you kill him once. He's dead. He died twice, I guess. But he has all these stacks.
Yeah.
Like, if EG is able to get a play where they go and kill the stacks there, they auto-win the game, it feels like. And I think they might be able to do that when Jug hits... when Queen hits 6. Like, they can... The problem is, EG has Undying to protect the stack as well. So...
Super has to not die here. Like, it's really important for him not to die here.
Yeah. Like, this is one of those games where this Undying is only going to be used defensively until Spiritbreaker gets, like, some farm. And then, like, the way Undying will be used aggressively this game is when SF gets levels and farm. That's when they can start farm-manning with SF and Undying.
Well, what's going to take is one Fissure here for a kill, but... Fear, just out of range.
And he's gonna be waiting a bit too long, it looks like.
This is, I think, yeah, full back, farm your stack. You know queen 6, so staying in lane is just a death trap.
Mmm, stack time.
Missed it again.
You know what? VG with those, they'll send...
He missed two stacks there.
They'll send
actually pretty big.
They'll send roommate mid to farm the stack, to get experience mid, and Undying and SF will share the experience there. Like, they want to get Undying level 5. Yeah, Rubik's, looks like Rubik's going mid.
No smoke.
And look at EG, they're kind of sitting on mid as well.
Yeah,
Does Peter have a smoke?
Fear's bringing one right now.
Yeah, it's on Korea.
So it looks like they want to smoke into, Artur's gonna TP there, I think.
Yeah, and go for the stack.
Looks like.
Mm-hmm. Who's the ideal hero to go for, like, with the TP? Do you go for, like, a Fissure Omni slash kill an Anti-Mage, or do you go for, like, an easier kill somewhere
else? Yeah,
look at
Artur, he's gonna TP, or they're gonna smoke into SF jungle and get a ward up.
Okay. Yeah.
VG should... This is kind of hard for VG to really think, because, they don't really have any wards out right now on VG, like, any good wards. And looks like,
They will see no one farming bottom lane, and... Yeah, the lane's pushed up, but it's still, like, it's a solo Spirit Breaker. In theory, Jug should be there farming.
Yeah.
This is a secret mission right now.
Okay, I mean, VG, SF and AM are hugging a lane together.
They know.
They definitely
This is really good from VG.
Yeah,
they saw
it.
Him move from bottom. And Spiritbreaker's just chilling down there. He's like, yeah, they're not here.
He knows. And he's okay to die here if it means, like,
honestly,
space for his
SF
team.
Should just TP bottom.
They already committed in. They got the lift as Arteezy. Wanted to make the jump onto FY. Look at this. They're even going to commit inside Sumail's here,
Burning
too.
Burning should go and buy TP and just TP bottom, honestly.
Well,
he shouldn't stay in this lane. Like, they should just sack this tower.
Yep.
Like, they should give EG
exactly
the tower, and then Burning needs to go bottom lane right now. He needs to TP there right now, or just run there. And SF needs to push in mid.
No, I'm gonna jungle.
Like, what a play is, if Burning was down here, Fear would be dead here.
Ice is level 6.
Might die anyway.
Yeah. If he gets a single bash, TP coming in, and it'll be the retreat now.
Like, that TP by Fear was not good. But it's good because Burning is on position. Like, he's on the right place. He's kind of just farming here, and it's a problem with their lineup. Like, it's SF.
They had the ward seeing Burning, yeah. So they knew he wasn't down there.
Yeah, it's a problem with SF and Anti-Mage. Like, you have these two heroes that don't really do anything. Like, there's no threat of, like, you know, the both heroes are just gonna be farming.
Ooh, looks looking like for the kill now.
Fear's camping him though. Really good positioning by Fear.
He's still going for it. They've got a lift and a couple raises, perhaps.
Yeah, this might be too much for little universe.
First one missed.
Yeah.
Oh, Sumail commits in. The wall was dropped. There's gonna be the Sonic Wave, and they got the kill. Now they want FY here.
He's not
trying to find a little closet in the woods, but there's nowhere you can go. Double kill.
This is. What does Sumail have? Is he going Yules?
Looks like Yules.
Yeah, he's going Yules for the Spirit Breaker.
That build too.
Burning is farming. SF has nowhere to farm.
1-2-1 stats.
Oh, no mana void. That is
super sad game for VG right now. Like, this Undying, even though he got such a good farm, he got such high levels early, he just couldn't do anything because there was no hero for him to do anything with. Like, the only way VG could really have done anything is Barathrum just leaves bottom lane and goes with Undying, and they smoke mid and try and kill the queen. But without Spirit Break ulti, you can't even do that, really. Like, Queen will always be safe, because Shaker is just protecting. Like, think about it, the Shaker poke was super good, because it protects his Queen.
They're able to get a takedown once more, looks like, onto FY. Is possible Skirmish to break out mid lane? Nope, doesn't look like it, though.
He's got Omni Slash.
Yeah. VG just had too many things they wanted to jungle, and obviously an Undying who has to play defensively is more of a sad Undying.
Yeah.
So a bit too much greed from VG, EG capitalizing on it. Good rotations from Fear. He's getting almost 6 with Arcanes.
He does still have that Omni. He's already hustling them back behind the tower here.
Got mana for spin.
Spin, no TP, nothing else.
Oh no, super.
Ice will make it out and away, but uh-oh.
Oh, it's a good tombs placement though.
What can they do though?
Turning back, raise, super is gone. EG converge and they'll get another big win, 8-2 now.
Well, this lineup just doesn't work out. Like, it doesn't fit The heroes don't fit well with each other.
They lack a lot of things. They lack damage. I don't. Yeah, it's very weird.
Like this fight is okay. If they didn't have an anti-mage, if they had a hero down there that was fighting with them and they fought here, that was a good fight for VG. But like, look at the Spiritbreaker, used all his spells, and then SF just doesn't have any items. They're just basically trying to make space for anti-mage, but like this kind of games where AM has one, like right now VG has to play an uphill game.
This is 4 protect 1 burning right now. Yeah. This is just like classic old school like DK Dota where you're burning and everyone around him is just trying to create space and time.
The problem is they don't have a lineup to play 4 protect 1. Like, they don't have any spam. They don't have a Wyvern to defend their uphill. They don't have a Shaker. They don't have a Darkseer. They don't have any heroes to really stop the push when EG pushes. Because EG doesn't care if this anti-mage gets super fat. You know? Like, who cares if AM gets super fat? They have the heroes to be able to take care of him and deal with him. The only way that VG can really, like, do something is EG kind of fucks up a fight. Like, if they try and go for mid tower or Roshan, and, like, VG's able to get a really good tomb off and a good SF ulti off.
Yeah, it's really hard for them to kill anybody, though.
Yeah.
VG can't kill anybody with their heroes now.
Like, the only way they can kill this Jug is if Rubick is there with Spiritbreaker, and they both Rubick and the Spiritbreaker set up a kill.
Well, Sonic Wave back online. It looks like they're coming for burning, perhaps.
Uh-oh.
Fissure and Omni Slash?
Yep. Do they have the lockdown? They don't need. They have the burst. Burning is gone, and FY may be the one to follow here. Fear looking to hustle on
Tranquil
Inch.
Boots. trying to get that up. Echo.
Needs more time for Fissure, not happening.
Yo's finished up nice and early. 12 minutes. Looking good.
Looking good.
Looks like Ice is going Midas, because you know this game is going to go... The only way they're going to win is if this game goes super long. And they're charging Sumo. They need to kill him here. They actually just need to kill him. Because they saw Juggernaut bottom.
And he's on a 7 kill streak.
But there's
so
a ward
a
on the bottom rune, so...
They see the charge.
But that Yule's already coming into play. Tries to turn another strike, but Universe is gone.
This is a sad Spiritbreaker game.
VG gaming coming up short. Multiple fronts.
They're going to try YOLO play here with... A smoke.
They have to.
They're gonna try and kill Artur. Artur shouldn't die here though.
No mana.
No TP. No blade
here.
Okay, it's got clarity.
He should not die here.
Should not.
Artur.
10 seconds till blade here.
Don't die here.
He may die. Smoke's coming.
Yeah.
Is he gonna die? Where are you gonna go? Dire's middle tower is
He knows they're all missing.
They broke.
He's gonna run right
back
into him.
They know he's farming.
Oh!
They see him.
He should not react. His team's behind him now, though, and they already got a Weave off. They got the Grave off. He's good. He's going to be able to just Blade Fury away. Super should be going down, and it looks like this could be another unfortunate fight for VG Gaming here. FY, the Prince could be falling here on the other front. Ice is going to be forced to just retreat the hell out. Prince goes down.
Godlike.
Don't worry, guys. Space for AM.
And he's already godlike. Are you freaking kidding me?
I think, I don't know, if you look at all the best of threes that VG's ever played versus EG, it's always generally been like this, okay, look.
Oh, goodness!
Too early. Blink hit?
Still dead.
Yeah.
He is dead.
Yeah. Okay, well.
Smell beyond god like 10, 14 minutes in. Wow. Can we get an LD wow in here?
Wow.
The help of the Earthshaker rotations, so that's also definitely credit to Fear.
Yeah. Is this like a record or something? 14 minute Beyond Godlike in pro game?
There's been 10, 11 minute ones, I think.
I think he's gotten 10, 11
minutes. Yeah, I think Sumail's actually done a lot better than this. Maybe not a lot. But.
I think generally though, VG kind of has a mental block whenever they play EG. Like, if you look at every best of three since TI4, they've always lost to EG, you know? Actually, I don't even think they played EG at TI4.
That's what Ice was saying in the interview that he did too. Yeah. He said like EG's our kryptonite.
Yeah,
every summit,
there's never
DAC is the most memorable.
Yeah.
That was the 3-0.
Yeah.
Like VG will be the best team in the world and they'll play EG and they just lose all confidence for some reason. Because they overthink, I think. Like, look at this, look at their draft. Like, that's not a VG draft. You know, it just doesn't fit their way they drafted.
So they didn't draft for the lineup, it looked like. It looks like they drafted more just like in response to EG.
Because right now, the way they're winning is the style they're playing is Burning is playing a lot of these douche heroes, you know?
And then, lately, yeah.
It kind of fits how they play, because FY in general is a very greedy player.
Yeah.
So, and especially this meta as well, like you can't, like AM is a very slow hero, so.
I'm gonna try for Artur again, but yeah, this is Fear's in position.
Even if Fear's not there, it feels like a long shot.
I mean, is it true, like, at the Frankfurt Major, when I, you know, when EG got their first series win, I believe, it was, I know for sure I had that first interview, and when you build around an AM with a proper, more 4 protect 1, some teams will just go to that when it's like, we really need to get a win. But
which game?
Who was it that EG played first in, was it OG? In the Frankfurt Major main stage?
Oh, it's Fnatic. Oh,
the first team they played at the main stage in Frankfurt.
In the winner
bracket. Vega. It was Vega.
Yeah, Vega. Yeah. So they got that. It went to three games.
That was a free anti-mage game, that third game, because Vega had no stuns.
No stuns, yeah. Yes.
Dire's middle tower. Like, Vega had a Gyro, Undying, Clockwork, Dazzle, Windranger. Like, literally only a Shackle to kill anti-mage, and Artur just had complete free from all game.
So sometimes, it, you know, it just happens to fall into place, but here
it's
kind of
like
not.
A Huskar, you know? You get these games with anti-mage, it's a free game. It's like yesterday's E-Home versus Liquid game. Even though C2I was, like, clowning around with his item builds, like, no matter how hard he tried a 3-2-2, they just couldn't, because the AM was just too strong.
Yeah.
Versus, Liquid's draft.
EG scouts enemy jungle, sees nobody there.
Super.
Goes to their jungle. Burning might get caught here.
This is such a sad Shadow Fiend right now.
The Shadow Friend.
Yeah, he's pretty
What does he even buy?
It's like, he's just smoking. Too late for mech, it feels like. Rush a BKB even?
Bots the smoke.
I mean, Secret had this kind of game versus the team IG at TI5, remember that game? Like, Secret just completely snowballed the game, and Burning at anti-mage, and then IG, it was like the one game IG
won. Oh, they came back? That was like a Burning AM crazy.
But he was,
game.
The
problem
he was
is that their draft was so good, like, that IG's draft was so good at prolonging the game. Because they had Storm Spirit.
They had Gyro mid that game.
Yeah, okay, they had a Gyro mid.
Oh, that was the Secret Gyro mid game.
Oh, they had Darkseer. That's
why. Darkseer.
Yeah, they had Darkseer. So.
There's like a huge play.
They got like this Darkseer vacuum into Mana Void off. Yep. What does VG have to really defend uphill?
And Shamil's so far ahead, he's just going to itemize to catch the AM. Like, looks like he's going right into a Hex after Yule Scepter, not even worrying about any kind of defensive or HP type item.
Yeah.
Yeah, he already didn't commit for the Orchid, so...
Yeah.
Something to chase down that AM. He's gonna have a Hex really soon, too. Might even get it before 20 minutes.
Just feels like this VG base is gonna be made of, like, paper mache. They have no way to really stop it.
This is like a...
the Samil show right here.
No Roche needed. Let's go high ground. They're, like, pushing bottom lane right next to the Roche.
What you gonna do?
You know, don't worry, guys. The VG has Darkseer Vacuum into Earthshaker Echo. Oh, wait.
That's their team.
Yeah.
They might just style on them in their own base, which they're doing right now. Double ulties. Already one kill.
Big vacuum.
It's not looking good. Already a buyback going to be forced out from Super. We haven't even gotten to 20 minutes yet. We could see the GG called here already. They'll hold on, though. They're trying to fight back. Nice. Committed with another strike. Pop! Echo follow-up, though. And
wow.
Yeah.
Too little, too late, though.
Yeah. AM's gonna buy back, but he's just gonna battle through. He doesn't have ultimate.
Okay, nice. Arteezy died to Shadow Fiend. And looks like.
Oh, okay.
EG just 3-2-2'd.
Uh oh.
It
cost a lot. Really it cost a lot.
Two buybacks on the VT side, I believe.
We'll fight.
Yeah.
We'll see that.
SF and AM, both cores, lost money during that.
Like,
That's still a win for EG, even though they give up Arteezy.
Slight setback.
Super got the kill though on Jug. And did Super buy out there?
Yeah, he bought out, so he didn't get much money. He lost money during the fight, despite the kills.
I mean, right now, the only way VG can theoretically win this game is if they can, like, get a Roshan.
Yep.
And get Aegis on anti-mage.
Well, if they can farm the Vlad, maybe just try and run in and sneak it.
He's waiting for his timer to run out.
What needs to happen is Burning needs to get the godlike streak off of Sumail, and then they do Roshan.
Yeah.
But that is...
Sumail needs to play with his feet here in a moment.
But the thing about EG as a team, it's hard to get, like, the way they play, they're one of the harder teams to really, like...
I think Quap is coming with a Hex.
Yep.
Oh yeah.
And he's got 1400.
It's a pretty good item at 20 minutes with the Yules.
Okay, EG is gonna run back bottom.
They've seen the Hex, that's the good news.
I mean, if EG wants to be safe, they're just gonna Roshan. So... yeah, they're gonna see Burning TP
top. I think
they're
going for the racks now. They know there's no buybacks. They probably feel really strong right now.
Yeah, Artur just...
they're pinging it up.
Looks like Artur just pinged the racks.
Goes first item Battle Fury, just wants to racks.
Yeah. And this is where the game comes down to. Can EG 3-2-2 this?
I don't think so. They're gonna get a range Rax nice and easily.
Let's see if they can do it though. Already the weave out, one Rax down.
Echo's not up just yet.
Daryl says never mind. Coming in from there.
Blink coming out.
He wants to kill Burning.
Yep, there it is. Already. Got it.
Yep, vacuum wall. VG are not really gonna have a response.
Bible bump.
Move in.
Oh, style points for FY, yeah. You know?
Healing ward it back.
Yeah, they need to kill Slim Shady.
Okay.
Oh, Spirit Breaker got the kill, not SF, but.
Still. Ice is pretty happy about that.
Okay, they need to kill that.
Okay.
Shaker there. Shaker has Blink, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Get it before the grave.
Steals it.
Dude, Ice is getting so much out of this.
Got hit by the Death Requiem. He's gonna Echo, though.
Oh, no.
Boom!
Tanky!
Fine. Stolen Fisher! God. Got it! Saves Daryl, able to make it back in away here.
Oh, no. FY.
Slice apart.
Okay, 17%! 17%!
Nope. No, that was like 4 hits with nothing!
You need like 5 70%, sir.
Ugh.
Close? Spirit Breaker got a lot of gold.
GG.
Yeah, GG'd out.
They lost the rack. Both carries died, so...
why'd you take your glasses off, dude? Don't be like that.
Because that was hard to watch, he doesn't want to see anymore. That's why he took the glasses off, duh. Well, unfortunately, VG Gaming not off to a good start from the draft point.
Bit too greedy, like we were saying.
Yeah.
You know, that Rubick pick, greedy, anti-mage pick,
I had to use the bathroom before this game, and I just didn't get to use it. Thank God this was a fast game.
I told you
there was a dumping. It just happened in the game. That's all.
Wow.